Hi, my name is Guy Wallace, and in this packed video short, we're going to discuss the pilot testing, phase 5 of a modular curriculum development and acquisition effort, all part of the PAC processes for training and development. PAC is an acronym. It stands for Performance-Based, Accelerated, Customer and Stakeholder-Driven Training and Development of Any Blend. There are 6 phases in MCD. The 5th phase is pilot test. What we're doing here is planning and conducting what I like to call a full destructive test. If the instruction, if the learning, if the training can be broken, if it can be made to find the holes, the problems, before we do a general lease, then we need to do that here. We want to do an authentic full destructive test. We want to deploy or deliver this instruction, or if the content is to simply be accessed and used by the learners, we want to replicate that as authentically as possible. I've been writing about pilot testing for a long time. This is from a newsletter from the summer of 1994 where I discussed pilot testing. One of the things that I learned with the advent of laser printers was that pilot test materials often looked too polished, and that would throw the learners and the others in the pilot test, and they would think that these were finished materials, and they would go a bit nuts if there was anything wrong. And so I decided that I would take a stamp that was in red and mark it up, pilot materials for review purposes only, and I would stamp almost every page, and I would do the stamps crooked on this page and a different orientation on the next page and slop it up a bit so that they would not be so thrown by anything, small errors, which would then become mountains from the molehills of a typo. So I would do that to deal with the perception by the target audience participants, by the pilot participants, when they would find something that wasn't quite right. Another thing that I learned and started using a long time ago was I would produce a pilot test brochure and send that to the management and to the target audience that was going to be participating in the pilot test session. I wanted to manage their expectations. I wanted them to know that we were going to perhaps be doing longer days than typical, or if this was going to be done in e-learning, that we were going to bolt on to the e-learning experience a bunch of evaluations, that we were going to be evaluating the heck out of this instructional experience. We would do verbal debriefs and written evaluations in order to tease out what could possibly have been found to be wrong or problematic that might need to be addressed in the final phase of the MCD project, which would be revision and release. It's important that the target audiences are represented in pilot test sessions. However, I've been doing this for 30 years now, and what I've found over and over again is that my client would stack the deck. They would bring in what I would call management representatives, or, kiddingly, I would call them management spies, which is more indicative of their role. They were there to spy on the content to make sure that it wasn't silly or stupid. They were there to check the accuracy, the completeness, and the appropriateness of the content. For after all, the target audience couldn't do that. So the role of the management representatives was to help us assess the accuracy, completeness, and appropriateness of the content. However, we could never measure learning with them. Theoretically, they already knew it. And I hated it when they would tell me, "Guy, I didn't learn anything from this pilot test session." Well, duh. The target audience, however, can't tell us about whether something is accurate, complete, and appropriate. But we can measure learning with them. Now, it's tricky then to segregate the evaluation data and the impact from one group on the other when you're doing a deployment. However, my experience also is that when you do a deployment routinely in the future, there's going to be a mixed target audience in there most of the time. Not all of the time. It might be rookies off the street who have no clue and they're all starting off at ground zero. But in a lot of deployments of instruction, there's a mixed audience in the room, so to speak, whether that's online or in a physical room. But the target audience, that's the learners, might have different levels of experience and exposure to this content. And then the design needs to accommodate the adult learners with some experience and allow them to use their prior knowledge in the learning and acquisition of these new knowledge and skills. And that's always going to affect the learners that don't have that. So in our designs, we often try to accommodate our anticipation, if appropriate, of learners coming in who aren't starting at ground zero, who have some background and experience, and we're going to try to leverage that as part of the instructional experience for everyone. I've been practicing, publishing, and presenting on these methods since 1982. My recent book, Six Pack, covers all of this in great detail.